17, like at 17 years old, you don't have a boyfriend and you think you've been left out. And I remember feeling so bad about it. I felt like I was really missing out on something. Like, I don't have a skinny jean. I don't.
Inside of my mind, in hopes that I can see them. I pray that I can reach them. God only knows if I make it out of.
Have been trying to film this video for the 100th time and I'm just tired. Honestly, I'm tired. I can't, because I'll start talking, then all of a sudden another thought will come, then I'll remember something else, then I just get confused, and then shockingly I'm just scared of the camera after making about 20 videos, and today I feel nervous to film. Why is that so? I also don't know, but I thought, you know what, the last video I did, if you guys haven't watched it, it was a story time where I was talking of, you guys should just check it out. Then in that video, when I was watching that video, I was like, wow, this is the most comfortable I have ever been on camera. And I was like, what made me feel so comfortable to that extent? Maybe, just maybe, it's because I was having food in that video. So I was like, let me try this again. Let me try to bring food on the channel. Maybe, just maybe, it's a solution to this nervousness I am feeling. But today's haul is different from the last time. It's not popcorns, you guys. I just brought myself some juice and tried to make it look classy, tried to make it look bougie, because I mean, so we'll be taking mini breaks again in this video, but this time it's classy type of breaks, like, hey guys, hey you all, you know what I mean, like, just. Anyway, if you're clicking on this video for the first time, thank you so much for clicking on this video. Do not, and I mean do not leave this place without subscribing. Join the family. What are you waiting for? And if you're a returning one and you're here for the second, the third, the fourth, I don't know how many times you've been here, thank you so much to those that have been subscribing, commenting, liking, sharing. You guys are the real motivation. Thank you so much. We are almost clocking 1,000. Like 1,000. We reached 1,000 because you guys are really, really supportive. And I'm so grateful to each and every one of you guys that take your time to watch my crampy-ish videos that are not even that perfect. Thank you so much. But anyway, without me talking a whole lot, I want to talk to you guys about something. It's a little bit of chit-chat, points and whatnot, because I've been liking such type of videos. I feel like we can relate more that way. You guys get to know me compared to me just coming like, number one this, number two this. So the past few days, a few friends of mine had been sending me, different friends that is, right, sending me photos of me in high school, me in primary, me, like, for the whole week, different friends of mine were sending me photos of me, like, this is you some 5 years ago, don't forget where you come from, this is you. If I show you guys the photo, maybe I might show you guys, maybe I might not, but I doubt if I will, because those photos don't look, they don't look anything the way I look now. But I was like, why are these people sending me photos? And these are different people in different places, different locations, and they're all just reminding me, like, Miles, you see this photo, this was you, you see this is you. I was like, anyway, maybe it's just one of those moments, I just brushed it off. Then now, like, some 2 days ago, I was looking for a certain document in my document. So when I was looking for it, I found an ID of, I found a photo of me, like my ID, my identity card that I used for my grade 12 exams. When I looked at that photo, I was like, why is it that the past few weeks there's been so many, so much of things reminding me of my teenage life? Why? I don't want that. I just don't want to remember those moments, because we've grown. We are now the better version of us and whatnot. But when I was thinking about, when I was seeing those photos, they actually brought different, like, so many different memories. Looking at that version of me and the version I had, you know, compared to what I was some few years ago. And, like, those memories, those moments made me feel like, wow. There were certain things that I used to really think were important then, that now when I look back, I'm like, why was I even bothering myself about those things? And so I decided to make a video in that line. Like, maybe I should just share with you guys teenage life versus adult life, like the things that we as teenagers, when we are teenagers, worry about so much, and the things that now that I'm an adult, you're just like, why did I even used to worry about that? And the first one would be peer pressure, like peer pressure, influence, trending, like just wanting to be part of what everyone else is doing. I feel like as teenagers, we would want to do what everyone else is doing. what everyone else is wearing, how everyone else is looking like. Like, would worry so much about what's trending, like what's growing up. I thought, no, me, peer pressure didn't really affect me because I didn't join the gang of drinking, smoking, because they are like, I used to define peer pressure as you start drinking, you start smoking, and you just like join the bad crew. But looking back, I realized, no, actually, either me, I suffered with peer pressure. Now that's when I realized, but for me, it was something different. It was something, you know, like clothes related. You know how like clothes come on the market and everyone is buying them, like the Hey Mamas came and you just wanted to also have it, like, mommy, I want a Hey Mama, or maybe like this type of outfits. I remember so well when skinny jeans, like, you know, these skinny jeans, when they came on the market. Before that, we had like hipsters, but when skinny jeans came, I was in high school. I can remember that so well. I was in high school when skinny jeans came out, and almost everyone I knew, it was a boarding school, so almost everyone in the school had a skinny jean, and I didn't have any. And I remember feeling so bad about it. I felt like I was really missing out on something. Like, I don't have a skinny jean. I don't have a skinny jean. I told my mom, I'm going to study so much and I'm going to get 6 points so that you'd buy me a skinny jean. I remember that so well. Like, it just felt like I was missing out because I didn't have a skinny jean. Imagine. Now, past few months ago, I was checking my clothes, okay? I checked all my outfits, I checked all my clothes, and I started counting how many skinnies I have. And I just realized I had more than 30 skinny jeans. It made me remember, like, why was I even bothering myself about not having a skinny jean in high school? Look at today, you have like 30, 50 of them if I want to. And I'm saying this with all humility, and I'm saying this not to brag, but just to tell a young person out there that whatever you are bothering yourself about, or whatever you feel like you're lacking now, it's just a matter of time. You are going to have them, and have them, so many of them. So, like, as an adult, you just don't worry about trends. You just don't worry about what else, who is wearing this and whatnot. So, yeah, like, a teenager watching me, don't worry about whatsoever everyone is having now. You are going to have it, and there are going to be so many, okay? And then the second one would be that, as a teenager, we worry so much about our insecurities. You know, like, puberty is taking place, people are growing, people are changing. Like, that teenage stage of life is the most uncertain stage of life, because you just don't really know even what's happening to your own self. Like, your body starts to change, everything about you starts changing, and then like puberty happens, and one or the other, there's some people that, you know, puberty happens well for them, they just like, they are glowing. But for some of us, you know, it wasn't the situation. Personally, for me, like, when I was a teenager, I struggled with insecurities. Growing up, I never had so much of insecurities. I grew up around people that told me I was nice, my brothers, my mother, they were all positive energy. Until now, I really, really thank God for having people around me that are positive. So growing up, I never felt anything that much. Like, I just used to feel like I'm cool, I'm G like that. Then went to high school. Now, during high school, puberty came, okay. And then acne came in the picture. Like, that thing can really, really destroy your whole self-esteem, self-confidence. And there could be someone out there that is struggling, maybe not with acne, you're a teenager, you're struggling with maybe the way your body is shaped, the way your teeth, the way your mouth, the way your hair, the way your body shape, the way your feet, the way your fingers. There's so many insecurities that we have as teenagers, because we are looking at our friends, what they're doing, how they're looking, and you want to look like them, and you don't look like them, so that makes you cry. I understand totally. But now, as an adult, I've looked back and I'm like, why was I even worrying myself about such things? If there's a teenager out there that is crying, feeling bad about how their body is, or whatever, anything that it could be that is making you feel so bad and making you feel you're feeling low self-esteem, lack of confidence and all that, I'm just here to tell you as a big sister that, wait, you're going to glow, okay? Like, your glow up time is going to come. Don't even concentrate on that. Just know that puberty is going to be done. You're going to blow up. Then the third thing would be that as a teenager, you just struggle with friendship, because we still don't know who we are. It's even hard for us to even choose friends based on that. You just choose friends based on who's the coolest out of all of them, who is the smartest out of all of them, or who looks nice, and if you're not that, you find yourself trying to be part of the cool kids. You know, once in life, I feel like, I don't really know which stage of life, but there was a time in life when I wanted to be part of the cool kids. Like, I just wanted to be part of the people that are happening at school. Like, I wish I could be in that crew, like they are the most happening people. But today I look back and I'm like, why was I even, which crew was even cool? What crew did they even have? What about them was even cool? Nothing. Today I look at them, I'm like, was it this crew that I wanted to be part of? They're not even that cool, honestly. So like, as a teenager, you worry so much about wanting to be part of the cool crew, you want to be part of the cool guys, you want to be part of the girls happening, you want to be part of the girls that are looking what. But now as an adult, you just realize, no, one, two friends are enough. Three at most, more than enough for you to just do, because you get so busy with life, you get so busy with your business, you get so busy with your work, you get so busy with school, and just don't really have time for having thousands of friends. One, two are enough, and you're just like, so if you're out there as a teenager and you're thinking, no, I don't have friends, no, why? I want part of the cool kids, no, just don't even bother yourself. If you pass, you grow and you glow. Okay, and in the line of friendship, I would also think about relationships. You know, in the teenage stage, like the 14, 15, that's when we get to hear the word boyfriend so often. I feel like the first time I ever heard the word boyfriend, not heard, but said the word boyfriend out loud, it felt as if I was insulting. Like, my mother should not hear me say this. My father should not hear, boyfriend? But now when you start to grow, you start to hear the word boyfriend all over the place. Like as a teenager, I used to hear the word boyfriend so often, like my boyfriend, oh, my girlfriend. It was all over the place. Relationships, you know, like this one is dating this person. This one has got a boyfriend. This one has got a girlfriend. And if you're not part of the ones that are having boyfriends and girlfriends, you feel like, what's wrong? Is there something wrong with me? I also want to have a boyfriend. I also want to have a girlfriend. I'm not like, to some extent, I know some people that felt because they didn't have a boyfriend at 17, they thought they would never get married. Like, I'm too late. My friends have had boyfriends in their 14 and I'm 17. Like, at 17 years old, you don't have a boyfriend and you think you've been left out. Why? That's a whole lie. Like, that's a whole lie. Let me just tell you the whole truth. At 17, at 18, you don't have a boyfriend. You think you've, like, I'm late. This, no. There are so many guys you're going to meet in the future. You'll be laughing at the guys you used to crush on when you are 16, 17, 18. You'll be like, really? Was this guy even that cool? Like, he's not even nice anymore. Like, that's how much you look. Like, when you're an adult, you start to look at that like, that was the boy I used to crush on. Really? Like, it's not even worth it anymore. Like, there's some boys that I look back to, I'm like, I used to like that boy. Today, they're no longer my class. You know what I mean? But what I'm just trying to say is, don't let such things bother you. 17 year old, you 18, 19, even 20, 21 even. Like the issue of having a boyfriend and you feel like you remained behind. No. Honestly, you just focus on the most important things right now. Focus on your books, study, make your life better. Boys will always be there. Okay, guys. I just forgot my sip. I think I have mentioned almost... Yeah, I think I have mentioned almost the things that I was thinking about that I wanted to share with you guys and compare just the two. If you're a teenager and you can relate to the teenage stage of life, I want you to comment down below. And if you're an adult and you can relate to the adulting and the growing, you should comment down below what you guys are or which phase you are in. And if you in any way found this video nice, helpful, interesting, or anyway, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to share it, give it a like. Comment down below, and from me, it's bye.